Yo, they just uploaded YouTube Rewind. There's just one thing they forgot. I control the YouTube Rewind transitions. And how about showing something that's mine?
All right, so we're back off to Spain. Are you ready? Alright, so I hope you enjoyed that little intro. YouTube Rewind was really cool. They forgot a few things that I found quite important for YouTube history 2018. But anyway, in this tutorial I will be showing you how they created their transitions. They're pretty cool and I've seen them often lately, so I think it's kind of a trend going, so why not learn how to create them? And it's actually a little bit more sophisticated than you might think, but we're gonna do everything inside of Adobe Premiere Pro, which is really cool. And as you already know, we do have an Epic Transitions pack, which has a ton of customizabilities to create original and cool looking transitions in Adobe After Effects. I will put a link in the description below. And we're currently working on a transitions pack for Adobe Premiere Pro because most of the editing goes in Adobe Premiere Pro, and shifting to After Effects might not always be the best solution, but it's a little bit harder, so we'll need some time. But once that's ready, it will also have a link in the description below. So without further ado, let's open up Adobe Premiere Pro and get started. Alright, so here I am in Adobe Premiere Pro, and as you can see, I prepared these two video files, which you can download with the link in the description below, so you can follow along with the exact same footage as me. So here we have my intro, and then we have the kind of follow-up video. Nothing too big here. Actually, you can do it on whatever kind of video you have lying around. I will select these two video clips and I will drag them into a new sequence. So right here, I'm just gonna mute the audio layer for this tutorial. But what we wanna do is essentially, I'm taking my phone, blah, 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 and then I snap my fingers like right here. And you can actually see that with the audio. If you look carefully, you see this kind of peak in the waveform, and that means there is the transition starting. So we're going to cut away here. And what we wanna do is actually right on that snap, we also wanna transition maybe like 10 frames further in time, maybe 15. Let's try 15 or even 20. So 20 frames after the snap, the transition, the clip ends and we get into the next clip. So right here, what we want to do here is the first transition is actually a combination of two transitions they're using in the entire video clip. First, you have that kind of zoom in RGB split effect, which is really cool, but they took it a little step further. We're gonna see how to do that, and then afterwards we're gonna concentrate on the transition. Everything that you're gonna learn in this tutorial, you can also just combine with other effects and just be creative. It's not because I show you this one way that you can't use it in multiple ways. It's all stacking up effects. It's gonna be really clear to follow, so let's continue. So the first thing that we wanna do is create that RGB split effect. To do that, what you need to do is click on your original video layer and duplicate it on top. To do that, we're gonna hold Alt and drag it on top once and three times. So we need to see it three times right here. The reason why is RGB, red, green, blue, for example, three colors, three clips. We're going to isolate every single color clip into every specific color. To do that, we're going to Effects, Video Effects, Color Correction, and we're going to use the RGB, it's not here, so I'm going to just search for it, Color Balance RGB. So if we're going to apply that to my first video layer, we can go to the Effects Controls right here. In here, we can just isolate every single color. So we're going to zero out the green and zero out the blue, so we only have the reds still here. For the next clip, we're going to drag this effect again to it, And this time we zero out the red and the blue. And then once more to the bottom layer, and here we're gonna isolate the red and the green. So now we have every single color. You can see the top layer is red, the bottom layer, well, the middle layer is green, and then blue. So we can see the mix up here. To now combine these layers again to show the original colors, so there are two ways to do this. You can use the blending mode screen, but screen also has a possibility on brightening your effect, and that's not what you want. You want to be using lighten. Lighten, a lot of people don't know this, but lighten is a blending mode that doesn't enhance the brightness of your scene, but will blend the colors together and just blend your two clips together on top of each other. So that's what we need to do here. We're gonna do it for the top layer and the middle layer. The bottom layer can stay at blending mode normal because it's the bottom layer, so that's pretty clear. And then what we want to do is animate the scale here. To do that, I'm going to be using a effect distort transition. So right here, distort, and then transform. I'm going to apply that to my first layer. The reason why is here we can apply some motion blur afterwards, and we can do that with the scale property. So what I will do is click on the stopwatch for the scale at 100 right here, put that keyframe to the beginning, and click on the stopwatch to make a keyframe if you don't know how to do that. Then we're going to change the value to something like 300, something insane. And this one is going at the end. Then we can open up these effects and we can kind of soften this out. So if we open up the tab here for the scale, we can take this anchor point and just drag it to the right and just try to kind of make these parallel. But now it's going to slowly ramp up to that size. So currently we only animated the red channel here. So what we want to do is click on this video layer, go to the beginning of this timeline and click on the motion and copy this transform effect. But before we're going to copy this, we're already going to introduce a little bit of motion blur. To do that, we're going to uncheck the use composition shutter speed, and we're going to change the shutter angle to something like 180. Click on the transform, copy this, and paste it on the other clips. So now we want to do something that right now you don't see anything. You don't see any shift going. The reason why is because they're currently scaling up at the exact same speed. So that's not what you want. At the end, what you want to do is you want to scale up one a little bit more and the other a little bit less to really get that split kind of going on. The only problem that we have here is that the keyframes are at the end, and when you go to the end keyframe, you actually see the other clip. That's something that bothers me a lot. But yeah, what you can do here is just go one frame back and just put that keyframe over there for all of these. And now we can concentrate on kind of mixing up the scale here. So everything is set to 300. What we want to do is maybe the first one here, we're going to increase that to 350 maybe, and the second one to 250. So now we have a split movement going up, and boom, we're in the next clip. Cool. Another thing that we can do is now use this layer, just one of these layers, alt and drag them on top, and we're going to delete the color balance effect. And in here we want to shift the scale to last a little bit, well, shorter, and we're going to drag the first clip to the center of the clip. So what you see now is something kind of trippy. I'm staying here in the center, but kind of the RGB split effect is already happening. And then boom, I zoom in the next clip. And that just makes it a little bit more intense, a little bit more kind of advanced looking, and it just looks pretty cool in my opinion. So that's how to do that. Now let's get a look on how to do that one transition with the ripple effect in Adobe Premiere Pro. To do that, we're first going to kind of finalize the first clip. So I'm going to select everything and I'm just going to right click and nest this sequence and just click OK. So everything is tucked in nice together. And if you double click on that, you can just modify it right here. So that just makes our timeline look a little bit cleaner. But another reason why I'm doing that, currently I'm filming from a tripod and I kind of think tripods are boring kind of movement, especially in this case. So what I will do is go to my presets. And we have a preset pack called TC Camera Shake Preset. And if I open this up, we have a bunch of different shakes. And these are organic, real camera shakes. So I like to use like a low shake from a medium shot and apply that to my scene. And you're going to see that now we have some kind of camera movement, like someone is actually filming me. I just think that looks a little bit cooler in my opinion. But yeah, if you want these, I will put a link in the description below. But yeah, that's what I did in the original, so that's why I'm doing it again. So we have the transition. Already looks pretty cool, actually. And you can do this exact same transition to the second layer and just kind of RGB it in or something. So that's where it comes to becoming creative. Just do whatever you want to do, but I'm just going to copy exactly how they did it in YouTube Rewind. So the next thing that we want to do is create a new adjustment layer. We're going to create a new adjustment layer right here and click OK. Then we're going to drag this on top of this layer, and actually I want kind of 1/3 to be the beginning and 2/3 to last afterwards. So something like this. I'm just going to eyeball it a little bit, but I think this looks okay. And then I want to apply an effect called, go again to the video effects, distort. We're going to apply this turbulence displacement effect. So if we're going to apply this to my adjustment layer, you're going to see this ripple going on really, really cool. So for the amount, I'm just going to change it to 75. For the size, alt it to 75. And what I want to do is animate the evolution. The evolution is kind of the motion of the ripples. So what I want to do is go to the beginning and click on the stopwatch for the evolution right here. Then go to the end of the clip. And actually, I don't understand why it's not showing the exit. Okay, so yeah, Premiere tends to do some weird things from time to time. We all know that. We're going to change this to like something like 500, and now we have this kind of animation going on here of our ripple. I look kind of funny here. Yeah, I actually look better, don't you think? Okay, so what I will do here is animate up the amount of the ripple. So go to the center where the two clips connect, click on the adjustment layer, and click on the amount stopwatch for the turbulence displacement. Go to the beginning and change this to 0. And now after that, 0, and also put that at the end. So now we have kind of a ramp up and boom. The only problem here, and which they don't have in the YouTube original, the YouTube rewind clip, is that my face looks kind of really distorted, crazy. And kind of to balance the things out here, what we can do is use our footage, alt drag it on top, and here I'm normal, and I'm just going to change the blending mode again to lighten. And now we have some kind of artsy fartsy kind of a transition. And of course you can go in here and play around with the size. Maybe you want it a little bit less intense, like 50. And actually, I use 75. The reason why is because I was working on 4K footage. So it actually looks a little bit different. I'm going to change it to 35. And I think that's more like it, or 40. And let's preview this. I'm also going to make it a little bit more intense here in the center. Something like 150. Okay. And now to kind of really make these transitions smooth, again, open up the amount tab and here click on one of these first ones and just drag this anchor point and drag it down until you see kind of a parallel between these two, and do the same for this one here. Okay. So now it's really kind of ramping up and then slowly come to a stop. I'm actually going to make an endpoint here and an outpoint here. Go to sequence, render into out, so we have a smooth playback. And there we have it. So what you can do now is, of course, kind of speed it up. I think my adjustment layer is actually way, way too big. So what I will do is right here at the start, we'll create it like this. And then right here, we split the layer. And I kind of didn't take care of the animation time. But like right here, we're going to fade it out. And then just trim the adjustment layer. Okay. And then for the sound effects that really make this effect work, I actually used Epidemic Sound. So you can go to the sound effects tab and search for kind of whooshes. And right here, if we all show all the matches right here, you have plenty of whooshes that you can kind of combine and really get your sound effects on point. But everything like transitions, they work so much with sound. So this is really going to sell the effect. And if you want, you can actually use Epidemic Sound for free, 30 days long. And they're giving you that option if you click with the link in the description below. All right, and there we have it. So that's a little bit more like it. Play around with all these settings and see where you end up.
Alright, so that's it for this video tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel for more, and definitely hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. And also check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for any kind of digital creative. And if you buy something from the website, it helps to support this channel. So that would be awesome. I hope to see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.